starting up the ice. Boston College will get it through to Giles. Patrick Giles had it turned aside. Now he gets it and scores! The puck came right back to him, and Giles buries it, giving Boston College a 1-0 lead with his third goal of the season.
So BU makes a change once they get the puck in. And when they go into the change, they try to get into their 1-3-1, but they never get set in the neutral zone. In on the forecheck. What a forecheck coming in. McLaughlin is going to get to the puck. Abel looks over the wrong shoulder. And what a pass going the other way. Actually, Giles banks it in off of the right side of the goaltender. Back a couple of minutes. So good chances from BU. Despite being down 1-0 early on, they're going to get on the forecheck. Harper's going to get the puck in front of the net. Quick shot off. Spencer Knight comes out and powers out. And then right here, this is Fensori. Opens up the base, gets wide, little puck protection, gets by McGinnis too, tries to go to the backhand, but again, there's Spencer Knight. You know, this has got a little different vibe to it, a different mentality of this team. There's a sense of purpose with this team because I think they understand how good they can be.
McGinnis takes it for Moore, gives it down to Boldy in front, score! That was deflected in as Boston College on the power play has taken a 2-0 lead early on here in the first period.
What a shot. One of their great freshmen, Alex Newhook, coming in off the side. Take a look at how this elevates. I'm not sure if it hits a stick or if it hits just the body of Ashton Abel. Good rotation up top. Now there's going to be a little bit of room right there. And he's going to exit in his own. Actually, you know what? That's clean. That's the net that I saw. I thought it was a body that it hit. I mean, it completely rockets over Abel. What a release. Abel's trying to make sure that everything down low or middle is covered.
As we said, the defenseman at BU will often get involved in the offense, and Ferentz is one of the best. That's Ferentz up top, plays it down the Cockrell, in front, score! Tic-tac-toe, Curry buries it for the power play goal, and BU is on the board. Team-leading 15th of the year for Patrick Curry.
And a huge goal, understatement, to get them down now just by one. But what good puck pursuit, and then quick puck movement. Zegras is going to touch the puck on the left side. His pass to the middle of the ice. Watch number 13, and he's going to eventually get it back. He'll make some good movement with it. Right, coming up right here, he's going to support the play. And the puck's going to come back to him. Right here, he moves it out of that traffic. That sets up this play. Low to high, and then opening up.
Sent in here by Rassinen, but broken up there. And Mastro Simone coming back the other way. Mastro Simone to the doorstep. Sprawling save by Spencer Knight. 7 minutes remaining in the first period. 50 seconds on the power play. Newhook going in. Boldy on the follow. Took the good shot there, but a good save by Abel.
Oh, Newhook really can scoot. I mean, that was a scouting.
Bring it out. Mastro Simone, the drop pass. Zegras on the follow. It ping-pongs around and goes wide.
Almost went off of Ethan Phillips' body as he was driving far post.
Now Phillips tried to come away with it, but Zach Walker leads the charge. 2-on-1. Zach Walker going in with Giles on the follow.
Here and scored a highlight reel goal. Give and go, getting the puck back from Cotton. He's going to bring Skog in, and then he's going to go right by him. He's going to scoot by Skog and go to the front of the net. This time, Abel.
Arizona Coyotes on 26th overall back in 2017. Here's Cotton on the left side, trying to tuck it home at the last moment. He's so dangerous coming in with speed, but Abel stood his ground.
More, and this is where his specialty is. Power moves, comes around the net, tries to make it. There's Abel, though, very able in that regard, getting over there, and no rebound. So good core strength, good core leg power. Abel pushes off one side, seals off the other, but getting David Cotton hold on to the puck. Good battle down low by Walker. Again, there's McLaughlin. And this line, this fourth line, has been excellent.
On the follow now, it's taken into 3-on-2, developing for BU if they hurry. Corsia getting it over to the left side. Shot from Stevens and a save made by Knight. There for Boston College. Now the Eagles control. Here's Walker feeding it through. Coming in up the middle to the forehand. A kick save made to the rebound. Goes just wide. All the scoring has come in the first period. Now Cotton looking to change that. Off save! Oh, what a stop there by Abel as Hutsko. They battle Jake Wise down there in the corner. Using his size and strength to protect the puck. Can't get it out. Kept in there. Out behind it. It's centered. Madeline wants to get to Cotton. in the net. Off of Vlasic in the end, into the net, and a two-goal lead for the Eagles.
And there's Cotton around the net. And remember, the first goal was scored from a pass from behind the net, so working below the goal line. And the fourth line has been really good, working below the goal line. And it comes through again for the Eagles as one of their leaders finds it. And it does Karaman off the big defender, number seven, Vlasic. Hutzko's going to push it to the front. It's going to bounce off of Cotton, and then it goes off of the skate. Turn around. Watch seven coming right in your screen. Off his left skate, and Karam's right into the net. It's a dirty goal. It's a slimy goal. But you know what? If you're a BC Eagle,
a little bit of himself, a little more room there, but pretty obvious call for the official for the interference.
Four on four as Harper takes it down low to the doorstep. The follow, score! Ferentz buries it, and that'll make it a one-goal game, and it comes before the end of the penalty, so they will still get the full power play.
Well, one of your offensive catalysts comes through for you. Ferentz showing his skating ability. Little cross interchange up top. Puck is going to be brought down low by Harper. He's going to drive to the net. Ferentz is going to come in. Watch as Harper's going to bring it to the net. Here's Ferentz already reading, already moving towards the net. Really read the play well. Watch here. This far angle will show you. This wider angle, I mean, will show you. He's coming in off the far side right there, staying in between the BC defenders.
As it was broken up by David Cobb.
Yep.
50 seconds still in the power play. Ferentz wheeling in, takes it down to the doorstep. A little backhand flip pass there. The shot.
That's a goal.
Tie game on the power play goal from Patrick Harper. His 12th of the year. Tremendous passing on the power play for Boston University.
What a shot, TC. Harper sizzles this one up top, but it's the quick transition in the neutral zone that gets the puck back in. Here we go. Ferentz again gets the defender to go down, puts the puck back to the middle. Harper picks it up and doesn't hesitate. Remember in the second when they hesitated a few times? Not this time. Smokes it over the glove of Spencer Knight. What a crazy minute and a half or so here.
The seven overtime games this season, they have six ties. That one never quite made it through as the defense was packed in. But this comes from Cotton out in front. A dangerous moment as it bounced around off skates. Hutzko digging it out of the corner. Little cut back to the front of the net, but Abel was there holding his ground. Moore dropping it back. Zegras picks it off. Little flip move to try to get in down low. The follow, and the shot sails wide. Corsia was there center ice. Harper over on the far side to keep it in for BU. Pass to Mestro Simone. He scores! The forecheck leads to the turnover. The pass leads to the goal. And Boston University has come all the way back to take its first lead of the game with a 1:42 to go.
Holy smokes. Oh my, has BU turned the tide in this third period? And Robert Mastro Simone, whose name we have called a lot in this third period, is going to get a gorgeous pass from Trevor Zegras. We talked all game long about Zegras' ability to find his teammates at times when they're not ready. Well, this time Mastro Simone was ready. A bullet pass. Folks, that is a perfectly executed pass.
Slides back over to his left. Boldy looking. It never made it through. Loose puck as they battle for it. Boston College keeps it in. The pass to Madela. Down low to Cotton. He gets it back. He scores! Are you kidding me? BC on the power play ties it up with 58 seconds to go.
Now this is a beanpot game. This is it. This is what helped make this tournament so dramatic and so fun. Puck has moved around up top. Cotton gets it back. Newhook, I think accidentally, actually kicks it back to him. Down low, yeah, he does. It's a perfect flub right back to Cotton, who then doesn't waste any time. And the goaltender, Abel, has to commit to the front. Tuning at one end of the ice, Mastro Simone's going to try and bust right through the gut. Finkelstein's there. So is Matala at the end. But at the other end of the ice, the quick shot from the point, Abel finds it, has it hit him off the body, and then because of his good positioning, plops right down into his pads, and he holds on to it. 15 or 17 seconds here. Here's the quick pass up. Here's Harper. He's going to fend off the defender more. Tries to lob it over the glove. Do that little soft shot over the glove, getting the defender, or getting the goaltender. He wants to get him leaning a bit. Instead, he ends up putting it right into that Eagles crest. And then just at the end, Zegras again looking to make one of his great passes. That
flips it up ahead, and the defenseman gets after it. Battling with Mattila down low. That was Jesper Mattila, the defenseman. Now Brink with the shot, and the rebound goes wide.
That's the old shot with purpose. That's exactly what I'm talking about. Get it on the pad, try and get a rebound.
Here's Vlasic stepping up. He fires it on net. Spencer Knight to save. The rebound. Score! Wilmer Skoog in overtime. The second overtime. And he scores his third goal of the year for the Boston University Terriers, who are moving on to the Beanpot Final.
It's going to be all about Skoog and getting away, but Vlasic's shot is literally shooting for a rebound. Brink is occupying the one defender in front. Skoog comes from the weak side, and he puts it in to the open side of the net. Excellent read. Newhook is occupied there with Brink, and then comes Skoog. Stick on the ice. Now is also a lefty, so his stick is to the inside. Provides him with a great lane and a great opportunity. And you know what? It almost looks like there that the goaltender Knight was trying to shuffle it out of there again, just kind of punch it. And he almost puts it right, watch, right there. He puts it right back, actually, to Skoog.